Life is beautiful because it is created by the beautiful Savior. Living life is an art. If we know the creator, the artist who has done our life, if only knew his mind and heart, and if only we are in his hands, our life will be always fulfilling the purpose for which it was created, and naturally it will be life-giving. It will become source of life to many. I remember this incident when Abraham took his son Isaac to offer Isaac to the Lord. Now Isaac and the father Abraham both walked together. The boy is carrying the fire. The sword is carried by Abraham, and the wood is carried by the boy. And the boy asks, "Daddy, there is fire, there is knife, there is wood. Where is the offering, Daddy? Where is the lamb?" The daddy says, "My son, when we follow the Lord, everything that is needed for our lives are not given at a time. We only receive his command and move on in faith. And what is needed for us in that particular moment, God himself will supply." Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's why he named God Yahweh Yireh, one who will look after us, one who will take care of us. Yes. Whatever may be our situation, we are not just jumped from somewhere else, from our mother's womb. No. Even before our parents have planned us, we are in the thoughts of God. God has sent us into the world, and as long as he wants us, we will live. The moment he wants us to return back, we have to return. So we are beautifully made and perfectly guided by God. Blessed is the man who walks with that God and make his or her life beautiful. In today's first reading, we find the apostles, Peter, John, and others, they were preaching the word of God. They were not afraid because yesterday we got beatings. No. But the elders and others, they get so angry. Because problem comes, you don't stop. Because stone comes, the tree doesn't stop bearing fruit. The children of God who carry the vision and mission of God, they have life only when they continue to proclaim him. We can proclaim many things. I can proclaim my talents. I can proclaim many things. My money, my family name, this and that. These are rubbish. In front of, if I don't proclaim him, all that God has given will become rubbish. If I proclaim him, all that God has given me will have meaning. So the disciples were not afraid because yesterday they were beaten up. They knew their mission and they were continuously proclaiming the word of God. The enemies once again came. They caught. Now they determined to finish them off. When you walk with God, certain problems will make you to think that you have come to an end. But soon you will realize you have a mighty God. You have not come to an end, but there is a bend, and God will take you in another. That is his trend. Praise the Lord. Another direction he will take us. And suddenly God raised up Gamaliel, a respected man, and God told through Gamaliel to the people who want to murder, kill the apostles, "If this is from God, you cannot stop it. Don't fight against God. If it is from human beings, it will be lost. Actually, God had kept Gamaliel there. He brought Gamaliel for his purpose. Gamaliel did not know he is an anointed man. The words he gave is coming from God himself. Because God makes the way where there seems to be no way. Now they have finalized to kill him, kill the apostles. But God raises up Gamaliel. And not only God raised up Gamaliel, whereby they were freed, though with little beatings, but then a new platform is created. Next day, they came to the temple. They started to preach courageously. Jesus is the Lord. Repent for your sin. Return to God and God will rebuild you. Now nobody is catching them. Because they decided, if it is from God, we cannot. If it is from man, it will die by itself. They built. God gives a base. Not only God works in us, second, he breaks the barrier. Third, he also builds up a platform for us. Do you go through problems, struggles in your life? And if you look at yourself with your power, with your knowledge, with the things that are happening all around or what others are talking about, you too may be thinking like those high priests, how to get out of this problem. Getting out of the problem is not our life. If there has to be, if you have to enjoy the light, you have to go through darkness. There is no other way. If you have to have a good crop in the rainy season, you have to face summer season. There is no other way. These are the beautiful ways through which God is at work in us. That's why in the book of Ephesians, chapter 3, verse 20, open your hearts and see your God is at work in you. The book of Philippians, chapter 2, verse 13, God is not only merely working in you, he has a plan for you before you were born, and God is at work in you in fulfilling that plan of God. That's why in the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse 18 onwards, God says, open your eyes and see. Your God is at work in you. Your God is doing new things in you. What are the new things he does? He opens the river in the desert. What? In the desert? Till yesterday, your life is a desert. When you walk in God, in the right time comes, he will make your life a pool of living water. According to the rule of the Egyptians, a ruler has to be 30 years of old. Joseph, when he was 14 years old, he was sold out in Egypt. And when he reached the age 30, the right time, God raised him up. The vision what he gave him when he was a little boy was fulfilled after 16 years. And in the age of 30 he reached, he became the ruler and all the dreams are fulfilled. For that God has to train him for 16 years, thrown into the jail, this and that, temptation from the master's wife, all that. You have to become worthy through your life. So when you go through struggles, God is training you to become worthy, to receive the great gift God has kept for you. God has not left you. Yes, in the fire, the mud which is having gold is thrown, and then the fire, the mud all goes away, then the gold comes out. God is at work in you. This you have to be aware. You are here not by yourself and not by yourself. You are here by God and for God. The more, the earlier you realize this truth, your life is going to flourish. If you don't realize it, you will struggle with your life, with your problem, and you will never reach anywhere. We are created by God and for God, and He is at work in us. We are created by God. Second, God is at work in you. When God is at work in you, you can be confident and move in life.